Hello and welcome to this video on how to design a detailed solar plant like this from scratch. In this video, I'll cover multiple aspects of designing, like creating your site, creating obstructions, and placing your panels on your chosen rooftop. This video will help you understand the importance of solar designing and why designing is essential before you start constructing the plant. So without further ado, let's get started with our first design. There are many kinds of solar designs, from small residential plants to large-scale solar parks. However, one thing all professional solar plants have in common is that they start right here, on a computer screen. Solar designing is an art that helps the client or site owner understand the feasibility of installing a solar plant. It helps them visualize the site, forecast the energy generation, and estimate the returns on investment. Having a visual and graphical understanding of the site helps the client confidently make the decision to switch to solar energy. For today's video, we have been approached by an international airport to install solar panels on their rooftop. We log into our Helioscope dashboard to design this project. Let's begin by clicking on New Project and entering our project name and site address. I'm going to pan around to point to the rooftop that I plan to build the project on. In our case, we'll use this terminal and create a new project. We'll click on New and launch our design window. Before we start the actual design, let's take a few seconds to analyze our rooftop. Here, we see the rooftop boundaries and a few obstructions and walkways. We'll make note of these to be used later. To begin designing, let's click on New under Mechanical and carefully start tracing our rooftop by its edges. Once done, on the left you can choose your module brand and model number, the type of racking, height of the building, the azimuth and tilt angles, preferred orientation, and you can specify the row spacing. Many of these options are set by default, however you can experiment with them to increase your generation. If these items seem confusing to you, you can join RioJob's live online classes where we break down the importance of each item and guide you on creating a detailed design report. More on that in the end of the video. After you've placed your panels, we need to create roof obstructions where you cannot place your panels. For example, this dome needs to be excluded since it's higher than the rest of the roof. Similarly, we cannot place panels here and here. To mark these obstructions, let's trace them in the Key Parts tab. We'll start with this dome and give it a height of 2 meters. We'll continue to trace the rest of the obstructions just like that. Sometimes you may have similar obstructions, and instead of tracing them individually, you can simply duplicate them just like this. You can always further tune your tracing to ensure accurate designs. You may have noticed that after adding these obstructions, some panels on this rooftop may have been deleted, like in this zone. This happens because the software calculates the shadow profile of the obstruction and removes any panels that are partially or fully shaded. Understanding the importance of shading losses is essential to improve your plant's energy generation. If you take a look at the edges of the rooftop, the panels are always a few meters away. This is what is commonly known as a setback. Setbacks are often dependent on the local regulations and safety requirements. The closer the panels are to the edge of the roof, the riskier it is, as they may fall off the roof. You may add a different setback accordingly, but for this video, I'm going to leave the setback on 2 meters. And you can do so right here. Speaking of local regulations, in some countries you cannot exceed a certain plant size. In case you want to set an upper limit, you can set that right here. This will ensure that the design does not exceed this upper limit. The last step in this video is the electrical design. The electrical design lets us choose an inverter and our preferred electrical configuration. We'll start by typing in the brand name. The software will then calculate the number of inverters required, and it gives you a fairly accurate count. To optimize it further, you can edit the value here. Let's click and drag the inverter to a desired location where we plan to install them physically. In our case, I'll place a few inverters here. Do note, the position of the inverter greatly affects the cable losses. You can view the cable losses in the final report and make any adjustments if required later. Finally, Helioscope also generates a single line diagram. Here, you can view the interconnections of your various modules and inverters and their links to the airport service panel and to the grid. This concludes our design in Helioscope. Let's exit this window and simulate our project in the Reports tab. This report helps us understand the various losses in our system and also estimates the monthly generation of our power plant. You can find more information and details about your complete power plant below with a final layout diagram. You can export this report directly as PDF by clicking here, and also get a CAD file in the design tab. I've shared a link to download a complete fine-tuned PDF report and CAD file created by using this software. Bear in mind that solar designing is a vast subject and requires in-depth analysis and understanding of various factors like types of roof, orientation of your building, the preliminary design, component selection, losses, optimization, financial estimations, and much more. If you're interested to learn the skills of an expert solar designer and build advanced and detailed reports, you can join our live online class where we walk you through designing a solar plant in detail and discuss multiple case studies with you to help you understand the whole process much better. You can check out the page and send us your queries if you have any. Leave a comment below and let us know if you'd like us to design other buildings or structures or teach other design softwares. Thank you for watching, and we're looking forward to seeing you in class. Goodbye.